How do gas pumps shut off automatically? Is there a touch sensor, maybe a light sensor, or a tiny camera inside the nozzle? Well, actually, none of these are true, and the process is 100% mechanical. The entire process is made possible by the small hole at the end of the pump. As gas starts flowing into your car, suction is applied by the small hole using an ingenious physics effect called the Venturi effect. The best way to think about this is a garden hose. See, if you pinch the middle of a garden hose, then you will back up water, increasing the pressure and reducing the velocity before the point at which you pinched. Conversely, on the other side, you will reduce the pressure and increase the velocity as less liquid will be flowing through the hose throughout this portion. What you may have not realized is that this change in pressure and velocity creates a vacuum at the point you pinched. This is the Venturi effect. Gas pumps use the same mechanism to create a vacuum. As the large flow of gas through the hose is constricted into the nozzle, a vacuum is created at the point of constriction. In gas pumps, this is achieved by the use of a Venturi ring. As a vacuum is created in the vacuum chamber located above the point of constriction, or the Venturi ring, the suction is channeled through a small hole we were initially talking about. So, gasoline is flowing through the nozzle into the tank, and gases are being sucked up into the small hole. As long as the small hole is able to suck in gases, the suction created by the vacuum chamber remains constant. However, when a drop of gas goes into the small hole, the suction required to pull the drop of gasoline up is significantly higher than just gases. See, sucking air in through a straw is much easier than sucking up water or any liquid. This same principle applies here. Until now, the vacuum chamber was constantly being filled up by the gases inside the tank. But as the vacuum chamber struggles to pull up the gasoline, a vacuum is created. The pressure inside the chamber continues to decrease until it reaches a specific threshold, and when this threshold is met, an auto shutoff pin is released which pulls up the handle and resets the switch that keeps the gas flowing. So, according to this, the gas pump shouldn't shut off until gas inside the tank reaches the brim and blocks a hole at the end of the nozzle. But we all know that this is not true, as we are able to top off the gas tank, often adding a gallon or more after it shuts off. So clearly, it's not actually filled to brim. So why did the gas pump shut off then? Well, the issue is that we don't have direct access to the main gas tank. We have to fill gas down through a small hose that's connected to the main gas tank. Just think about it as a funnel. If you're trying to fill a large container using a funnel, you will have to pour very slowly, or else the funnel will overflow as the liquid slowly trickles through the small hole. Ideally, the car manufacturer designed the small hose to where it backs up the instant at which the gas tank is full, but not topped to the brim. However, they can only account for so many factors, and many external factors can cause the pump to stop prematurely. For instance, over several years, as residue builds upon the walls of the hose, less gas will be needed for the hose to back up and stop the flow of gas. It could also be a problem with the gas pump or gas itself. If you are finding that a specific gas pump always shuts off prematurely, it could either be that the gas flows too fast from that pump or that it has some sort of pressure calibration issue inside the pump. Finally, this could also be caused by gas that is foamy or too dense. If you are constantly facing this issue despite which gas pump you go to, you may want to check out if the rubber hose down to your gas tank is partially collapsed or clogged and get it replaced or cleaned. Or of course, you could just manually fill it up, being careful not to fill it up too high. And that leaves just one more question on the table. Should you top your gas after a gas pump shuts off, or if you're filling it up manually, should you fill it up to the brim to delay your next visit to the gas station? And the answer is absolutely not. If you want to find out why, then make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for that video coming out very soon. Also, if you guys found this video informative, then make sure to drop a like. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.